Almost every day I see comments and I get comments on my videos and posts on Google Plus that people doesn't understand how to use an iPad as I do and what an iPad really can do and how powerful and advanced an iPad really is if you know the tricks like I do and you know what an iPad really can do. For example, in iMovie for iPad, I always get the comments then that people prefer to video edit on their Macs in Final Cut Pro X instead because they can do so much more things in Final Cut Pro X. But I'm not sure that they know what iMovie for iPad really can do. It's not Hollywood we're talking about here. It's normal people and usually YouTube videos. And I'm sure that these people that uses Final Cut Pro X on their Macs doesn't do more effects or edit their videos more than I do on my iPad. I think they are doing the same things as I do, especially for YouTube videos. So I am sure that they don't know that iMovie can do these stuff on their iPad. For example, it's very easy to change the audio for a video on iMovie for iPad. Or adding an image, you can add an image side by side while still talking. You can add an image instead of yourself over your audio, or you can add another video side by side or over the video you are editing and so on. Really easy. And you can add text and so on to the video. Really easy. And you can do intros and outros and so on very easily in iMovie for iPad. And I'm sure that these people, they don't need more than that. I'm sure they don't use as blue screens and so on that you can do in Final Cut Pro X. I'm sure they are happy with what you can do in iMovie for iPad if you know how to do it. But it's so easy to write a comment on a video or a comment on a post and say that I rather prefer using Final Cut Pro X because I can do so much more in it instead of knowing how to do it on the iMovie on your iPad. It's so much easier to just post a comment and say that I can't do what I need to do on the iPad. And it's the same thing with a lot of apps and things I do. For example, there is not many users that know that you can use an app like Clips and clip content from the web and directly blog it from the web by using a blog template that you can create in Clips. So you have everything marked up in Markdown, ready to post on your blog. I don't think that there is many people that know that. And I don't think there is many people that know that you can do your own Python scripts in Editorial for iPad and iPhone. So you can do a Python script, a really advanced Python script to do very automated tasks when writing in Markdown in Editorial. You can automate almost anything. You can, for example, if you type the word Apple, you can automatically link that word to a blog post on your blog or a video on your YouTube channel, for example. Totally automatically, you don't have to do anything. Just type the word Apple. Really easy in Editorial. And you can add an image to your Markdown code directly in Editorial by using a Python script you have created before that uploads that image to your storage place on the web and then link that into your text. You are basically limitless on the iPad and iOS if you know how to do it, if you know the tricks. That's the huge difference between the Android and iOS too. iOS makes your device limitless. Android is very limited thanks to the lack of apps. Thanks to all great apps on iOS, I can do anything I want on the iPad. There isn't anything at all that I can't do on my iPad that I want to do. And then people just say, but why? It's so much hassle to do that stuff on the iPad. But no, it's actually easier and faster to do when you know the tricks and when you have learned to do stuff really fast and easy, then I can see anything that I can do faster on my Mac that I can do on my iPad. It's actually the other way around for me, because I've tried go back to my MacBook Air, but I think it's so much hassle to create content and upload and sharing content everywhere on the Mac, because I need to do most of the stuff in the web browser when sharing and so on, and I don't like that. I need native apps to share my content, and thanks to the new support for extensions and the share sheet menu on iOS 8, this makes it so easy compared to OS 10 on the Mac, because all the apps are connected to each other. You can do stuff between them, multitasking between the apps, because you can send contents between them using extensions and share sheets. So this is why I think it's so easy to, for example, share my latest YouTube video to all the different communities on Google Plus, my own profile, my Google Plus page, Twitter, Facebook, Pinterest, Flipboard, and so on, by just doing some short clicks and choosing the right extensions and share sheets. So easy, it takes just a few seconds for me to share everywhere. So this was quite a long vlog about me trying to explain to you that you can do a lot of the stuff you do on a computer as easy and even faster on your iPad if you know the tricks and know how to do it. Okay, bye.